Hello everyone. If you've been watching my crystal radio videos, you notice that I use a lot of this type of fuse tube to put detectors inside. And this will allow me to mount and dismount the detector very easily. So today I want to show you how to make this. Okay, so this one is for the crystal. You have the cap whisker that touches the crystal inside. Let me show you what is inside. So if you remove the cap, you see this little wire. This is actually a spring, a wire taken from the spring. The spring can be from your ballpoint pen. You have a spring in each ballpoint pen, you can get that from there. Or even better, you can get a guitar string. Find the one which is the thickest, which looks like springs. This is usually the base cord of the guitar string. So cut out a piece from there and it will form a very nice cat whisker for you. Then just find some way to secure it at the tip of a copper wire that you can put a handle on. Okay, and then drill a very small hole at the cap of the fuse tube so you can push this in. For the little crystal holder, it's a bit more complex. So I have a small cam like this. I have another spring here and another copper nail connect to two pieces of copper plates that I cut out that looks like a claw, a small clamp. So and then it pass through a small copper tube here because the spring is loaded, so it can work like a clamp. So you can cut your crystal into small pieces that can fit within the glass tube of a fuse tube like this one, and then you can put it in. Okay, then you can put in the cat whisker and try to touch the sensitive area of that tiny crystal when you try to tune and listen to the radio. Another way to create the cat whisker is using a screw. Okay, this time you need to drill a hole just big enough to screw this copper screw in. This is a M3 screw. So you can screw this in. And then cut out a small piece of the string, whether it's from the guitar string or from the spring of our ballpoint pen. So curve it such that it can be mounted at the tip of the copper screw. Okay, and then you can put it inside the fuse tip, and then you can screw it and adjust and touch the crystal. For the holder itself, you can buy this type of holder for the fuse tube and then just solder into your circuit board at the right distance so it can allow you to mount this tiny crystal holder. Okay. A lot of us try to break into a fuse tube, and sometimes it's successful, sometimes it's not successful because the fuse tube is really very tight. So if you are not successful in doing that, then I suggest you can try something else. You can just crack the glass, take a cap out, and then buy some of this plastic transparent tube here. This transparent plastic tube looks like a fuse tube, so you can do whatever you like, mount any LED diode or even other type of detectors like MOSFET, and then put the cap on. So this is another way to make one, but the tube is made of plastic instead of glass. I also have a video that show you how to clean a transparent plastic tube. I can share the link of that video in the YouTube description. You can clean one using a transparent filament. The transparent filament won't be as transparent as your plastic tube here or the glass tube. You see lines as it's being printed by the 3D printer, so it's not very transparent, but at least you know something is inside. If you really can't take off the glass and you want to fit some smaller diode inside, the other way is to drill two big holes just big enough for the diode to pass through at both ends of the cap, and then put the diode inside and then solder both ends to seal it up. That will make a good use of the tube for the diode. I want to show you how I mount the 3DQ at the same time. So this is the 3DQ. So I mount it using the 4-pin jumper and a circuit board. The leftmost one is the G2, and then D, S, and G1. And I just solder it to this 4-pin here. So I can use a socket like this on my circuit board and use it to mount the 3DQ. At the same time, if I want to convert it to a tube holder, to a fuse tube holder, I can use this circuit board. Then I can put in the crystal like this. So it allows me to mix and match different type of detectors during testing.
I hope you liked the video. If so, please share with your friends and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye now.